Born in Pakistan, Dr. Shah graduated from medical school at Punjab University at the age of 22, at a time when girls and women were typically not attending university, let alone medical school. Her mother had not been permitted to go to school past the fourth grade because she was a girl. Dr. Shah arrived in the U.S. in 1968 in Boston, where she was told she would not be allowed to perform surgeries in the U.S. because she was a woman.
Young women today may not realize that it wasn't long ago when if a woman wanted to seek a professional life, it wasn't that easy. And it is true for the medical profession. People often have asked me a question, were you discriminated against because you were from another country and spoke English with an accent? And I said, you know, the funny thing is, people accepted me as a professional from another country who spoke in English as an accent. People had more concerns and reservations about me being a woman. So I would say discriminated, because in the 60s and 70s, for instance, in 1968, when I came to United States, I had embarked upon a career in surgery. And my goal in life at that time as a young, ambitious doctor was to become the first woman cardiovascular surgeon in the world. And when I came to United States and tried to get into the surgery program, I was shocked that they did not accept the women medical residents into the surgery program. And so things have come a long way since that time, and now 50% of the pediatricians are women, and in all academic facilities in the medical school, there are women academicians, there are researchers. So things have come a long way, but it wasn't that easy. And so I think for those of us who are my age or in that generation, we learn how to pass those hurdles. And I learned that if somebody says you can't do it, I have to prove that I can do it. Easiest way to get me to do things is say, you can't do it because you're a woman.
Dr. Shah has been at this for 30 years. Her ability to work with others and draw the best out of them is unlike anybody I've ever seen. She has this quiet passion about her that comes out whenever she visits with someone. She allows them to see in themselves what they don't see, what she sees. And her ability to get children, to get families, to get providers, to see the best in others and to draw the best out of them is an absolute wonderful trait that she possesses, and something that is infectious around the hospital.
In the 1960s and early 70s in the United States, there was virtually no acknowledgement that children were being sexually abused. A turning point in Dr. Shah's life was the day she observed a three-year-old boy brought into the emergency room who was forced to wait hours for treatment and was re-traumatized by seeing others being treated for bullet wounds, heart attacks, and accidents. After Dr. Shah examined the child and determined there had been sexual abuse, she became one of only five pediatricians in the whole of the U.S. who began to address the treatment of sexually abused children. She not only developed clinics to treat the children, she also had to educate doctors, lawyers, and counselors about this tragic area of healthcare.
In 1985, when I started my clinic for diagnosis of child sexual abuse in Broadlands, there were only four other doctors in the United States that were using the special diagnostic equipment that I used. And before we introduced the colposcopic examination, the only way child sexual abuse could be prosecuted was if a child got sexually transmitted disease or became pregnant. So that introduction of that special diagnostic procedure changed the whole scenario for diagnosing. And so I didn't realize that until I went into a conference that there was only five of us that were doing that. Now there are hundreds of those.
This year happens to be the 10th anniversary for the Regional Child Protection Center here at Blank Children's Hospital. There is no way this would have happened without Dr. Rizwan Shah. Her vision, her passion, her energy for those kids that are in the most difficult situations has made this center a success. Literally thousands of children and their families have benefited from her wise advice, from her energy and her passion to keep kids safe. nobody gave us a chance that this would survive 10 years. And it's not just surviving, but it's a national landmark for regional child protection centers in the country. And that's due to Dr. Shah. She's the most unassuming person you'll meet. She's probably embarrassed at the recognition that she gets tonight. It's our pleasure to dote on her because her commitment, she is always there. She always answers the phone. It could be the chief of police, it could be her neighbor, and it could be a four-year-old little girl that looks up to her and says, "You talk funny, but I like you." And she is the one that's there for all of those. And so it's just the way she is. Most organizations have somebody in their midst that's so well known, they only need one name. For us, it's Rizwan. All you have to say is Rizwan, and the nods, "Yes, we know who you're talking about. Oh yes, Rizwan." She's that popular.